Hello, I'm Izzy Jones, and I play SJ in Purple Beatz. So SJ is just quite a normal girl from Bournemouth, and she wants to sing, she wants to be a singer, and she wants to make music, and she goes to London with that dream, as many people do, and she gets a bit lost, as many people do. And I think the thing that excited me the most is that I had that. I went to London, I came, because this is where it's all happening. And I didn't get as lost, but you know, she makes it through in the end. So it's about connecting to the creativity instead of the industry. So yeah. Interesting, in the 90s, I wish I actually grew up properly in the 90s, because it was epic. I think the shift in the styles, especially in London, I think there's a lot to be said for the different styles of music and how that encapsulates like the heart of the culture of London. And so to choose drum and bass, to choose the 90s, which was like the pinnacle of that time, is probably the best time to explore that and to explore the relationship between the industry and singers who go with a vision and get caught up in that. Yeah.
You talk about the musical demands of the role, because obviously they had you singing a cappella quite a bit in this one.
Yeah, they did. So for some, I had an earpiece, which was really helpful, but others I just had to sort of keep singing a cappella, styling it out and improvising some bits, so that was really fun. I actually loved it, the singing element. It's not something I get to do as an actor usually, so yeah, it was fun.
What does it mean for you to be a part specifically of the I Will Tell festival?
It's brilliant. It's really brilliant. Like, I think anything that supports unique stories, different voices, it's the best part about festivals like this, is that you get to see things that aren't usually given the platform. And so it's brilliant to be part of it. It's so nice. I'm really excited.
Hi, my name is Jason Matthews, and I'm the producer of Purple Beatz. And yeah, we're here for a great evening and hope everyone enjoys it. We're really looking forward to everyone seeing the film. So this is a coming-of-age drama. It's set back in the 90s, 1996 to be specific, when this young woman, she travels from Bournemouth to London to make it in the music industry. And of course, it's a coming-of-age movie then, where she meets all the trials and tribulations that that you might expect through the music industry being as fierce as it is, especially back in the day. And also, I mean, even in today's standard, for a woman to tackle that is even perhaps more difficult than their counterpart. So in that regard, it's a really beautiful story about her finding not just herself, but also her music, her sound, and finding her way to navigate that treacherous path in London, or indeed in any other city in the world. I first of all loved the script, and Lola, when I spoke with her, she asked me to produce the film, and you know, not all the time do you get the creatives who have such a clear vision of what it is they want to do. And sometimes you do get them with a clear vision, but what they want to do is way outside the remit of possibility or budget or whatever. And Lola seemed to have it like really in check in both of those areas. And also, as I explained a little earlier, a little bit about the film, we are not by any means reinventing the wheel here. But what we are doing is telling a story from a perspective that maybe doesn't as often get to tell that story, but certainly didn't get to tell that story back in 1996. So to come on and to support a group of filmmakers as they are, to tell a story as it is, I just really wanted to support that. Honestly, I was blown away by some of the performances. Her lead, of course, Izzy Jones, she had a mammoth task in that she wasn't only acting, but she was also singing for, I think, like maybe nearly every track within the film, it's a cappella. And she did do that a cappella. And it wasn't, you know, she's singing Rachel Fox's music, and Rachel's here somewhere today, I believe. So she had a really tough task in that. And then, of course, we have Aaron Van Ander, a young German actor, who, to be honest with you, I was blown away when I realized the guy was German, because his Cockney accent is on point. Without going into the, without passing and going into cliche, he really nailed that kind of coked up Cockney douchebag role, and I love Aaron, he's great, but like he nailed that, he nailed it. Erica as well, Erica Anderson, Erica Alexandra, beg your pardon, she was amazing as Dee Dee. I mean, the cast was phenomenal across the board, and I think really, really representative of what we want to be telling today.
So music is literally my life, and drum and bass is what I grew up on, like in the 90s. And there's something about drum and bass that's just so raw and authentic that, you know, and it's so London that it really just needs its own presence. And obviously it's around music, love and music as well. So it was a bit, I wouldn't say challenging, but I think it was just for, I feel it's like my homage to the 90s really, that we can tell a beautiful love story with music as well at the same time. So yeah, I think that's just in a nutshell really, yeah. Well, do you know, we shot during the pandemic and we had to create at least quite a few rave scenes. And as you can imagine, that was a nightmare because, you know, everyone, you know, getting a bunch of people in a space with, you know, it was like, please God, let there be no outbreaks on set. But thankfully, the rave scenes were amazing. We were able to capture all the energy, the vibe, and the music as well. We were able to just get all of it. We had some of the drum and bass pioneers like Ronnie Size, who also features in the movie, and Kenny Ken, you know. So I was able to reach out to these guys that, come, you know, you are like the pioneers of drum and bass. Come and feature my movie. Come and just do some DJ move. And it worked, thankfully, you know. I think it's a sound that still needs its voice, if you know what I mean. So, yeah. The casting process was interesting because I needed a female lead who can not only sing but also act. So she needed to be like, a double-edged sword, basically. Very good at actress, but also a very good singer. And we found that in Izzy Jones. She's amazing. She was, although her thing is jazz, you know, blues, she's not really a drum and bass kind of girl, but she was able to kind of like, you know, a lot of young people who don't know, who are not of the 90s, probably don't even know the sound. So to try and immense her was pretty much very easy, because she's a brilliant actress. So I'm super proud of what she's done and what she's brought to the character. And all the other guys, they were all amazing, you know, from Russell D, who's played by Michael O'Hara. And then we have Aaron, who plays Russell. Russell D plays him. Air Beatz is played by Stephen. I'm getting them all mixed up now. And of course, then we've got Erica Alexander, who plays Dee Dee. You know, they were just amazing guys. Super proud of what they've done. And When we were approached by I Would Tell and said that they would like to screen us, we were like super like, what, really? You know, because before, I've never come across the platform, but I was away from it for quite a few years. But I Would Tell, to me, is literally given a platform for, you know, for all kind of, all creatives, you know, all creed, all race, and just given us the platform to showcase our work, our art, which is kind of like very difficult, you know, in the industry right now. But, you know, women are coming through, and we are given platforms now to share our stories, to share the world we live in, not being told by a male's narrative, but from a woman's narrative, and that's fantastic. And I Would Tell is literally one of the forces that's driving that, which is fantastic, yeah.
How important do you think that is for women to take control of their own narratives on screen, both in front of the camera and now increasingly behind?
I think it's so important now. I think we're just tired of just hearing stories, or even female-led stories, for example, being told from a male's perspective. You know, it's like the DNA, but it can be changed and it should change. I think it's time women should be able to tell our own stories, our own, you know, our own journeys, and have that, you know, feminine touch, if you want to call it. I don't know, but I think it's important that we do have that opportunity to do that. And you know, my on the film, we had female HODs, you know, from the DOP to sound to costume, they were all female. I was very very intentional about that I wanted to have female HODs, and we got that. So yeah, I think it's important that things should change, and we're part of that change, and I'm happy to be a part of the change. Never give up. I would say just keep on pushing regardless what comes your way. And that's the story of the film, really. You know, we follow a young lady's journey through challenges when it comes to finding her musical voice, and you know, and she never gave up, and she got there in the end. So I hope when people see it, they'll be like, oh my God, you know, let me give a shot at that thing I wanted to give a shot at, you know. And if Lola can do it, so can I. So yeah.
Hi, my name is Aaron Von Andrun.
How does it feel to be premiering the film here at the BFI of all places?
It feels amazing. Super grateful. I'm just excited that everyone gets to see this film. I really believe in the story and I think it's an important one to see. So I think, it feels amazing. It feels great. I play Russell D. He's a music exec and he sees the lead character of the film singing at an open mic night and hears her talent and basically gets her to sign a dodgy deal with him. He's kind of, he portrays the dark side of the music and entertainment industry. So he starts to take full advantage of her and that's all I can say really. You've got to watch the film.
You talk about working with Izzy in front of the camera and of course Lola behind the camera.
Amazing. Had one of the best experiences working with Izzy. Super, super talented actress. I was kind of blown away by her performance at first, the subtlety and the emotion, but then when she started singing, I was completely blown away. She's, just a multi-talented performer. It was an amazing experience. She's a sweetheart and she just made it all really easy. Lola, same really, just great working with her, great writer. I'm just grateful that she gave me the opportunity. I'd love to work with her again. She's a great, great director. I just shot a film in America called The Blind, which is about Phil Robinson and will be released in cinemas next year. And then played a small role in the new Indiana Jones, which will be coming out next year. And a small part in House of the Dragon, which is the new Game of Thrones prequel. And then that's about it, really.
Indiana Jones, is that something you grew up with? And what was it like seeing Harrison back in that absolutely iconic outfit?
Insane. I mean, I was more of a Star Wars fan. I'm like die-hard Star Wars fan. So when I saw him, I think it was the first time I was really speechless because I just saw Han Solo. And it was incredible. It's mad at his age to still be doing action films to that degree. And yeah, it was just a dream, really, to work with one of your heroes, and he's just obviously an amazing, amazing actor in person, and just really grateful to have the opportunity. Yeah.
I mean, like you say, people thought he was mad when they said they were going to do another one with him heading towards his 80s. Do you think that fans will be convinced by him as an action star when they see the finished product, though?
100%. I was actually so shocked at how he was so fit, in such good shape. I mean, better shape than I'm in. And I exercise in gym a lot. Like, I mean, that guy is, I mean, incredible. I mean, I heard that he cycles for a couple of hours before like a 6 a.m. shoot start. And at his age, I mean, that guy's been keeping fit and healthy for a long time. And people are not gonna be shocked at all. Like, he's just as, he does just as many stunts and action moves in that one as all the other ones. And he does most of them himself, so it's pretty mad.
You get a chance to work with any of the other amazing cast on that one because it's a smorgasbord of talent, you know, Toby Jones.
I worked with Mads Mikkelsen. I worked with Boyd Holbrook. Phoebe Waller-Bridge is in my scene. I didn't really work with her, but she's in the scene, but in a different part of it. But I met her, and that was incredible. Working most with Boyd and Mads, which was just like, I mean, Mads Mikkelsen is like one of my favorite actors of all time. And Boyd Holbrook is honestly one of the most humble, sweet people I've ever met. And working with him was honestly one of the best experiences I've ever had. He's such a giving actor and he's such a nice guy and just so humble. I love Boyd, basically, is what I'm saying.
It must have been a really mad set to be a part of, because when we see the set photos, and because obviously the story spans time periods a bit, there's everything from Roman centurions over here to Nazi soldiers over there. It must have been weird, like, what's going on today?
Every single day I was like, what? Yeah, completely confused on what's going on. It was completely insane. But they've definitely pulled it off. I don't know how, and I think it's going to be one of the best action movies. Because it's so ambitious to do something like that. But I feel like Indiana Jones always does that. But I think this time they've taken it to kind of a whole new level. And I'm just so proud to be a part of it. Just a small role, but still, I'm very excited for people to see it.
House of Dragon. Obviously, we've got a premiere coming up for that soon with Matt and the rest of the gang in Leicester Square. Can you talk about what it meant for you to be a part of that? Were you a Thrones fan addict before you stepped into this world?
Yeah. Again, I'm only in one episode, but my experience on that was just one of the best I've ever had. And Game of Thrones is genuinely my favorite series of all time, and I was just like the biggest fan. So I would have literally done anything. I would have been just a tree in the background, just to be there. It was insane. The scale of what they shoot, it's just crazy. The sets, the locations, amazing experience. Yeah.
My name is Jenny Lee. I'm the founder and director of the I Will Tell International Film Festival. So we are about celebrating untold stories that bring freedom, power and change. I initially started it because I felt the world was desperately in need of more love, and a number of different experiences led me to telling stories as a way of doing that. People whose stories would often not be told or will be told, like tonight's film, a story that may have been told before but not through this perspective, not through the eyes of the people who are showing it and also the cast and crew that are doing it. So it's really about celebrating untold stories that challenge our perspectives and catalyze change. There are different levels that this story speaks. At the industry level, it's significant because it's but an ethnically diverse crew, a predominantly female crew. We've got a black female British director, which is a rare breed. And so I was really, really excited just to support Lola just for that reason, because we need to have more voices getting this kind of exposure. On the more just enjoying the art of the film, it's a wonderful independent film. And I'll try not to spoil it, but the characters and the relationships and the arc of the change is really, really well done. And it also raises some interesting issues. We always like, you know, the world has issues and we don't shy away from them. So it also raises important issues about young people and drugs and, you know, just finding your way, which I think would be useful for people to think about.
Why is tonight here at the BFI such a very special venue for you guys to be sharing the film and the festival with people?
Yeah, well, it's the British Film Institute. It's the heart of the independent film industry. And it's a real honor. We've been wanting to get into here for ages. So when they finally said yes a few months ago, it's fantastic. And then we got the choice of choosing which film would do it, which is amazing. But the BFI has got so much wealth and history of significant independent films and wonderful talent. And so to be here is significant for us and for the film as well.